What's up, everybody? Sneaking in with the little DQB.
Let me make sure I'm not echoed. Got the audio turned out there. I'll even pause that.
Good evening, everybody. I got some stuff to stream tonight. This is not the only thing I'm going to be streaming this evening.
Sophie here.
I have been playing a lot of Dragon Quest Builders. I don't know if you saw Ben's stream. My castle's just a teeny bit further along. Because this is like one of my most anticipated games this year. And this game is just like everything I want. They did it. Hey, everybody. I'm still in chapter one. I am well developed in this game, but I am not playing this game fast. As you can see, Rolo, my buddy in there, who's cleaning up his room. I actually just figured out how rooms work. I thought I had it right, but I was wrong. Rolo here clearly wants to warn me of an impending attack that we have on the base that we'll do. We'll probably do. I think I'm going to play this for about an hour because you guys know I got at 10 p.m. tonight. I will be playing some Red Dead, Undead Nightmare specifically. I figure for the next hour, let's play some DQB and just kind of, I'll show you. We talk about it, hang out. I was going to play it anyway. I wrote my script today for Gears of War 4, finished that up, and. And pass that to Mr. Bloodworth. I noticed I just got it back from Bloodworth. I will read that probably before I go to bed tonight and then cut that tomorrow. But I was like, hey, for the next hour before Red Dead, let me play a little Dragon Quest Builders, take a little break. I was like, hey, let me stream Dragon Quest Builders. So yeah, so here's my town. So if for those of you that didn't watch the stream that aren't really kind of caught up on the game is basically Minecraft and Animal Crossing and Dragon Quest put together. So all the people you're seeing around me are in my little village. And they all have specific rooms that are assigned to them, except for you, Pippa. You and I are going to be building our rooms in just a second. You can see I got my place where all the smelting happens. Armor is made. I have a room. No, Magnus. Magnus, I'm good. We've already had this conversation. Cool, Magnus. I wish you could drop out of conversations, which you can't, if you've already had them. I got my stonemason's workshop. I got a dressing room over here, which was previously my bedroom, but didn't work out that way. Pippa's crashing in here, which is cool. That's smart, Pippa. Cool, crashing here. Got a fireplace in there. I mean, there's all sorts of reasons why I'm just absolutely in love with this game. I mean, there's the Minecraft Infinity Lego Worlds angle, which I'm always, you know, hooked on. Yeah, you can't get in, buddy. You can't get in. Nice try. We have people trying to break in. So here's the area at large. This is as big as it can possibly be while still containing rooms that will activate as the rooms that they are. So you can't see it anymore, but when you start the game, they give you a lit plot, basically, that the music will change when you step out of it. So you're like, okay, I have to keep my village in here. So after playing the demo a bunch of times before this game came out, I was like, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to set up a wall of dirt around the whole thing. And then basically my whole town was kind of enclosed within that. So, again, I've just gone totally 100% overboard with this game. But, obviously it's fun to build things, but there's the mechanic where your place is going to be attacked. Some monsters are appearing right now before my base. They're getting absolutely destroyed. I want to go and watch them, but I think they're going to be dead before I get over there. Wait, here we go. So I have spikes laid out in front. And then there's actually a drop that goes down underneath the castle. And the castle, the drop is walled up on the outside, but just in case any of the people break in, I can hop down here. This is where I keep all my dirt, because you get a lot of dirt in this game. And so this is basically the length of the whole thing, so if they come crashing through these walls, I just kind of have this open room to fight them, and it keeps them away. It keeps them away from all the people upstairs. But most of the people just die before they even get in here. Like, this, maybe that'll change later on. Maybe they'll bring more people in for attacks. Again, I'm still in chapter one. But, my big boy's here. You can kind of see. What, you got a problem? What's up? I got a new broadsword. You can kind of see you can see it better during the day. Got a monster egg. Fry that later. But basically what I'm going to be doing, so, what's up, everybody? Yeah, no, this game has got me. It's just one of those games that you have every year. Everybody's got one or two of them every single year. that they wouldn't force on anyone. They wouldn't say, like, you gotta play this. They're just like, I don't know what it is. Whether it's, like, you know, Dance Dance Revolution or, you know, FIFA or just whatever. There's just that one type of game. For me, it's, like, games like this, like RPGs that I can customize, like, to an insane degree. And really good action stealth shooters for anywhere from, like, a Dishonored to a Metal Gear to, like, Far Cry Primal or, you know... anything with a bow and arrow in it, basically. So it's day. I wish nights were a little bit longer in this game. The transition from night to day is extremely fast, as you just saw. But actually, why are you up? That doesn't make sense. Hold on. So this thing right here says that this is LaRouche's room, and what I was messing up before is if I go to this menu and go to buildings and go to room recipes, you can see private bedroom. You need these things. You need the resident sign, which you just saw, a pot, which is random, and a bed. So I had the light source and the bed and the sign, but I didn't have pots in these rooms. I missed that tiny little detail. So I just today, earlier this afternoon, figured out how to do that. So I signed the rooms to everybody, and they clean them. Look, like the characters actually will like hang out in their rooms and like clean the floors, and they recognize that that's their room. And previously what I've been trying to do is I've been trying to sleep in this room, but this room was set as the armory, and I thought things could be two different things at the same time as long as they met the qualifications, but they can't. So I had a pot and the lights, you know, a heating source to make it a room, basically, and the armory qualifications over, you know, shadowed the fact that I thought this was a room that people could sleep in and stay in. That was incorrect. So the time has finally come because, as I explained, this is as big as this town can possibly be wide. I can still build up. If I think I build down, I can't put any official rooms down there. I mean, I can still, you know, dig as deep as I want, which is something else we could do tonight. That would be fun. If I build higher, you still get the happy music while you're in town. It'll still recognize when I try to build specific types of rooms. So if I'm going to expand my castle, I'm going to expand it up. Yeah, couch co-op, multiplayer. I mean, Ben was playing, I think, in an early save. I'm not sure how much Ben had played. And again, this game is all about priorities. Like, Ben was probably much further along in the actual story than I was. Like, when this game tells you to do specific things, Ben probably did those. I ignore everything this game tells me, and the second I get a new material, I make 100 of them, I obsess about it. You know, like, I really kind of take this game in. Just scratch. If you have specific questions, throw the Easy Allies name up, because that's what I'm logged into in chat. So what we're gonna do? So we got the staircase over here. This thing's really great for people who haven't played this game. This holds your old equipment and has two huge item things for if your bar on the bottom completely fills up, all of the excess will go to here, regardless of where you are in the world. So even if you're out and your inventory is totally filled up, it'll just send it here and you can deal with it when you come back. So sometimes it gets me in trouble when I'm trying to do specific quests, but I think that is a very cool feature that is definitely appreciated. So I'm gonna grab all these and that one. And we're gonna lay this out. So I'm not sure I want the doors to be yet, so I'm just gonna lay all of this down. Replace some of that. One thing that I like is that you can aim down. So the activity that I'm doing right now in Minecraft is actually extremely tiresome to do because you have to like aim a lot while you're on the side for the side. Like it's hard to like put a block on the block that you're on. And sometimes in Minecraft I would make bridges like really high in the air and it was just like really stressful. Like, and in this you just boop, 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 boop. As long as something is connected to another thing, at least horizontally, and of course beneath it, you can't just put a block in midair. You can build something and then cut the way of the blocks so that there are blocks in midair, but... I know how to make, as you can see, I have two different types of floor. I got the straw floor and the stone floor. I dig the straw floor for the rooms where people hang out in, and I like the stone floor for the big rooms. Is this the first or a later area? This is the first area that I was introduced to. The flag, if you played the demo, that's where I put my flag down. I never moved it from that spot. Because I think that's like right in the middle of the whole thing, so. So while this might be spoilers, because you can see some stuff in my base, like the door, which is cool that I just unlocked, it's not spoilers because I'm not going to be doing a lot of story stuff tonight. Again, I got about 50 minutes left before I'm going to be playing some Red Dead Redemption. No rush. I'm a little nervous about putting ceilings on stuff. Because the one thing that, one of the things I don't like about this game, we want to get a little critical, the camera in this game is bad. You can press R3 to reset it behind you. So, even though that's not, or just reset camera. Yeah, so if it's really close. Why is that not? Because I have something in my hands. Oh, weird. I don't know why that's not working. Weird. Like I said, camera's bad. But it just gets kind of muddy. Like, let's try to get down here. I wish there was like a first-person thing you can do. There's no way to set like how far if I want to be closer to him. You know, if I want to be like right next to him underneath this thing. So I'm nervous about like going into buildings. I just realized I need something else. Sub. Oh man. Oh, we got subs. Selgaco. You're a subscriber now. Came in that Red Dead move. Thank you for the update. Cool. Not sick of the music yet, surprisingly. See, like already these doors are hard to see. It's tricky, like how I'm gonna set this place up. I want the main square to be as open as possible. What do I need? No. Floor. Probably replace that straw floor with something. I do have this, which I grabbed. You see a castle later on. Yeah, and I grabbed one of these. I grabbed a castle tile, which is the floor in the castle. That's like the super posh regal tile. But I do not have that yet. Over there. Put in the thatch, if you will, for all these rooms, and I can pay. How much do I love Allstate? I do love Allstate. Not as much as I love Chevrolet. Chevrolet has been nicer to us than Allstate, but Allstate's pretty good. Allstate has lasted longer than Chevrolet. For people wondering what I'm talking about, my wife is in an Allstate commercial that has been running for a long, long, long time. So, thanks, Allstate. You never know. It's like TV shows. You never know what those commercials are going to be that the advertising company, the ad group from the, you know, clients and, you know, production people and the audience and everybody, they all love. And, people dig her spot. I'm also not 100% if this is going to be big enough. Like, I might want to move everything up, you know? See, this is the thing. I obsess about this. I think, oh no, I'm running out of floor too. Oh no, okay. How much floor do I have down here? I don't have to put all... Yeah, see, it's like I already can't see in there. Brutal. Yeah, I'm definitely going to move where that stuff is. Because that sucks. Finish these rooms over here before I do anything else. See, in Minecraft, you're always in first person. I think Minecraft, like, some of the building stuff you can just do quicker in Builders. But in Minecraft, you're in first person. So I think it increases the immersion just a little bit more. But this game is still sweet. And I can also just build more straw floor. Oh, so maybe that's what R3 does. Okay, hold on. Wait, let's do a test here. So I go indoors, and that shuts, and I can't see anything. R3, oh, goes into the room. Okay. Oh, it's really dark in here. Might have to put a sconce up on the wall there. What do I want to build? I want to build some floor. Straw flooring. So they have flooring in this game and walling or building or something. I don't know what it's called when it's in the walls. But will you guys get PSVR? Yes, we will. Tuesday, our group stream will be PSVR. You heard it here first, maybe. But yeah, we're going to be playing PSVR on our Tuesday stream. Yeehaw. Yes, please. Build 99 of that. Doodle-loop. Sweet. So yeah, what I'm going to do, I think, is I think I'm going to take, because... Oh, but then it's going to take a while to get up there. I'm going to have to think about that. Because I go in this room a lot to build stuff. I guess this is okay. And it's kind of jolly because it's on the first floor. I'll deal. Oh, things are attacking near my base. Oh, they're coming up near the back. Oh no. What are you guys going to do? Looks like you guys are having problems. You gonna try to get down there? It's not good when you get down there. You gotta walk really far to get to the ladder. Ooh, didn't work out. Okay, let's see if this guy, maybe. Oh, he really wants to smash that wall, but you got a little ooh. Sorry, buddy. Didn't work out. So rewarding. Took such a long time to build that whole thing, but, like, that's so rewarding for me to see that happen, like, to have this base. To build this little tower here and to climb up on it and, like, see stuff at a distance. Oh! Gotta eat food. Got my shrooms on a stick. Yeah, exactly. Summer lesson. I'm curious what the game's gonna be. What the favorite PSVR game is going to be of all the games. Like, Riggs looks interesting, but I don't know if I can play Riggs. Riggs might be a little bit too much for me. Okay. So we got... We're getting stonewalled here, literally. How much? No. Can I add a stonewall? No, I got more stonewall. No, I don't, because that's not something different. Okay. How much stone? Oop! You don't have to make that here. How much stonewall can I make? 80. Okay. Let me get some more stones. And then I have castle wall, which I've taken from another castle, which brings me to one of my favorite things about this game that I think is legitimately different from any video game I've ever played. Correct me if I'm wrong. And it's a beautiful day again. The sun's coming up. Everybody's waking up. I love this guy in the helmet there. Just guards. He never goes to bed. You can assign him a room. He'll never go. I mean, he'll probably go into it, but he'll never go to bed. He always stays up at night because he's a guard. Are all the allies adding this to this separately, or is this all you? Oh, this is all me. This is 100% Jones. This is Brandon. This is Jonestown. You're in Jonestown right now. Welcome to Jonestown. You should probably say welcome to Jonestown. Actually, no, because you're inside. People know it's in Jonestown. When you discover an area in this game, you can, like, rob it of its resources. So, like, I found a, there's a part of this game where you go into a pyramid. One of the second area you get to in this game is the desert, and you get to a pyramid, and you go inside, and all sorts of spooky stuff happens, but, I stole, like, 100 sconces. Like, I couldn't destroy the walls, but I could knock the sconces out, which made everything dark, but I could still find my way through if I had a torch. So I knocked all the sconces out, and now I have, like, 200 sconces. So if I want to put a bunch of sconces in my castle, I can. These guys, again, sorry. Slight spoilers. Oh, I haven't put it back in. Actually, okay, we won't spoilers. There were items, defensive items, that were set up in the pyramid that I knocked down, got in my inventory, stole, brought back home, and set up. So it's like, I have, castle walls that I have taken from castles I have found that are, I'm guessing, much cooler than the items I have right now. Whoops. To build castles. But I just don't have enough of it, and it would be a big pain. It's much quicker to just know how to build something and build it than, how tall are buildings? 3 things tall? I think it's 3. I just think that's a really cool element. Like, there's just it brings a whole new element to discovering a cool building for the first time. Because it's not just, oh, this is neat, and it's fun to walk around and explore. I see something, and I was like, oh man, can I take that? Like, that's a cool table, I want that. And I'll smash the table, and it'll go in my inventory, and it's like, cool. And I try to RP it, you know, like, I don't want to steal from people. If it's somebody's house, I'm not going to smash their stuff up. But the plot of this game is that this world is kind of besieged, and there's not a lot of survivors out. And every time you get to a major... Here we go. The castle's coming together. Look at that. Every time you hit a major milestone in the story, it opens up new survivors to show up. And so every time I hit a major breakthrough in the story, one of these new people showed up. The first being Pippa. Where the heck's Pippa? The buttons are super weird in this game. It's another complaint. Jump is circle? Jump is circle? Come on. Oh, I looked at the screen right as Koyuki Aihara. Subscribe with Twitch Prime. You're a subscriber now. Woo! You can subscribe with Twitch Prime for people that don't know. Some people reached out to me on social media and said, I don't think people know they can do that. So you can do that, everybody. It's very cool. Where should I put this door? Where should I put the door? And I need a door. Do you have any? Yeah. I want that wooden door. Actually, I need two wooden doors. Put it on here. See if I have the materials. Yep. Another one. Another huge complaint about this game. Huge complaint. You can build one of something or as many things as you could. Oh, there's Pippa. Hey, what's that? Oh, no, that's not Pippa. There's Pippa. Hey, Pippa was the first person. Pippa's very sassy. You can build one of something or as many as you can, provided the materials that you have. Up to 99. You can't build two of something manually unless you build something and then build it again. I think. I couldn't find a way to do that. I thought that was pretty dumb. And pretty obvious if you're trying to copy or one-upping Minecraft or something of the like. So here's the first. I don't think I'm putting it in there. Here. Yeah, put that there. So, you know, not to be like pompous or anything, but I want my room to be the biggest. So I'm gonna put my room up there. So these are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's go for 8. Let's see what 8 gets. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I have a cool view of like back here. Yeah, I can put it in like a window and I can see this like cool view. Yes. Smash you guys. You can change buttons in PS4. Well, yeah, you can change the buttons in the settings for the PS4, but I don't want to have to do that every single time I play the game. Does it set, remember that for every game? Why haven't I done that? Yeah, that's really cool. Wait, don't do that. And then I'll make Pippa's room. I'll make Pippa's room 5, because people seem to be okay with that. I'll make it 6. You're one of my OG members, Pip. I'll make your room 6 so you can have the door right in the middle there. What do you say to that, Pip? Rooms have to be 2 blocks high. And they gotta have a door. And a light source. And that is a room. One more day, Pippa. Tomorrow night, you're gonna be sleeping in your brand new room. Can't wait to get new beds. Surprised I don't have new beds. We're all sleeping on little paper mats on the floor. Eagerly anticipating the reveal of beds in this game. Oh no, what do I need? I need stone. Oh, I need coal. I got plenty of stone. I need coal. Okay. I'll go to bed and go and get coal. Not for stone, but at least have. I really want to finish that. Okay, wait. I might be able to. Wait, I might have a solve. That we can demonstrate something else that's cool. Do I have any more of this? Yeah, I got stone cladding. I'll use that. Which means. And again, I showed how dirt is extremely commonplace in this world. Everybody got dirt. You get dirt everywhere. When you set up the chests in these rooms, in these different special rooms, sometimes they'll put stuff in them, including dirt. Yeah, look, they're like, we swept up some dirt off the floor. There you go, there's some dirt. Like, the NPCs put that in there. I didn't. So, it's fun to go and, like, check up on them and see what they've built. So he's like, look, yep, got some dirt. You take care of that dirt for us? Like, yeah, sure, buddy. No problem.
Oops, I didn't mean to do that.
So now what I can do is I can build what I want to build with dirt, and then if I go to this stone clotting or cladding, and then you saw I did that like, he'll basically turn it all everything around that's specifically made of dirt and turn it into whatever it is, and in this case stone. So now I can build these whole rooms. And what's up, everybody? You gotta steal the nice bed from the castle ruins. Yeah, I guess I gotta go back. Okay, that the kid's in the castle ruins. Brandon, are you planning to stream this with Ben at some point, since you both are the most into it out of all the allies? Surprisingly, a lot of allies are into this. Ian actually asked me about this. Ian actually sent me a message and asked if you could be a female character, which you can. You can in the demo, which is weird, but you can in the actual game. And she's adorable. You can change your hair color. You can change your eye color. Yeah, this game has it all. Streaming with Ben would be a great idea. That would be super fun. Maybe we could do like a spoiler stream once I get into chapter 2, and if give people time to finish the game. And then maybe just once before the year wraps up, kind of when we're talking about our favorite games of the year. Oh no, guys, monsters appeared near my base. You guys, there's 3 skeletons attacking my base, you guys. There's only 1 skeleton left, but there's a skeleton attacking my base. Maybe I should go down there and take the skeleton on. Let me switch my broadsword and go, oh, okay, it's dead, never mind. It amuses me. I'm not ashamed to say. It puts a smile on my face. To know that I laid every one of those spikes, I burrowed that whole thing out. That wasn't something I unlocked. Like, whenever you have updates in games, Assassin's Creed is guilty of this, where it's like, The Witcher did this. The Witcher, when you get your winery, you get your own, town. Ranvarian is a subscriber now! Woo! Witcher has, congrats, man, thank you. Witcher has, upgrades that you can do to your home, which is awesome, but you basically press a button and it happens. It's like, where do you want us to upgrade first? Okay, we upgraded it, done. And that's great, but again, I just love when people take it to the next level. So look at this, boom, boom. All of this, done. Pippa's gonna be so excited. Okay, 6 of that left. So I gotta go get, put that away. So you can see I'm super anal about this. I have spikes, anything on fire, and this flooring and cladding, excuse me. Okay, let's put the dirt away. It's almost day, it is day. And it's day. You also can't move these anywhere specifically, which I am extremely anal sometimes with games like this. I like things to be where I want them to be, so that took a little while. You basically can just clean it up and organize it like that. That took a little while for me to adjust to, but it's fine. It's okay. I'll be alright. Oh, wait. Whoops. We need, mess that up. I can put this one down. I'll just grab a couple more, guys. So, we'll see who joins us for that stream with everybody. Somebody's saying something. Jones and Ben need to stream this, stream the free play mode. Please, I want to see you both battle the hordes as long as you can. The free play mode. Oh, sweet. Oh, awesome. I'm watching this on my PSVR right now. Oh, that's awesome, man. Man or woe man. Persan. I need beds. Excuse me, I need to make some beds. One straw mattress. 2 straw mattress. I need to make a gentleman sign too, and I don't think I have the materials for that for some reason.
Element Sign.
Not have materials. Blue goo, not enough. Need to go kill one of the iconic slimes in cold blood. And get the goo. And get two, just so I have one goo. Make it three. They're all over the place. I love that you don't get hurt by the spikes. You and the, all the people that in your village don't get hurt by the spikes. Like, hey, hey. Okay, that little camera switch, I can get used to that. Gentleman's side. Materials. Put away what I don't need. Put away. Actually, no, don't put. No, that was wrong. Something. Oh. Yeah, the rest of all of that. Pot, which I have. And then, let's see if there's any fun decorations we want to put and stuff. We got windows. We can put some windows in. We should maybe go build some more windows. Got stone windows. I'm not putting in stone stuff yet, so I think a wooden stool, sure. I'll give Pippa a, oh, they got a chic chair. Yeah, I'm definitely putting them in there. A chic chair. I got a buttress. Brick bulwarks. Wow, I don't know. Get involved with that yet. Those are the evil idols I'm gonna put out, gotta put out in front. Okay, fine, I'll put that up in my room because it's fancy. Pretty pillar. No, I'll leave the, maybe do that downstairs. Alright, cool. Up to the wall, okay. Just so that, yeah. Just don't remember that doing that. But I guess it does. Here, maybe a little stool. I'll put that over in the corner there. Put that over here. I'll give you a window, too. You need a light source. which... I'm gonna make a campfire for you. Campfire. There are campfires. Two campfires, please. Actually. Or bonfire. One bonfire. And, because I'm a fancy pants, I'm going to steal you. I wanted you to be in my room. Oh, and I'm also gonna. Oh, it, yeah. Okay, fine. Yes, yes, yes. So again, everything's conditional on how big it is. So it's like there's not a light source in the room that freaks out. Take you. You're gonna be in my room too. So yeah, the armory's back. Want to build an aerial garden and see how that would be. Yeah, that'd be cool. okay, so there. Yeah, you bet I do. Oh! My base grew up to level 5. Woohoo! Put my required pot.
And I'll sleep over in the corner here.
Gotta go steal that bed. Maybe that... Whoop, didn't mean to do that. Maybe that'll be our crunch.
This is my...
Can't sleep without... Wait,
what is this called?
I can't sleep without my stuffed hammer hood.
Cool chair.
Oh, wait, now I'll give you the... No, I won't steal. I'm taking the stuff.
Signs. These pots. Put away the rest of this here.
Oh, wait, no, actually keep that sign. That's my sign. Whoops. Don't put my sign up yet.
Campfire for her, and then I put the campfire, so I need to make another campfire.
We're getting there. Slowly but surely.
More fire, please.
This is a tree that's supposed to drop berries, but it hasn't done that yet, so.
I don't know if I'm doing something wrong there.
How did you... Oh, you got up there through there. I hate it when they do that. I might make the rooms one floor bigger. One that would make the walls one thing bigger.
Should I put the fire right there? Yes, I know, South Healing.
Okay. Build a private bedroom, so I can go over to this guy and say, who do I want this to be? And I say, Pippa. Because Pippa's the only female. It has to be gender specific, the sign that you put up, so mine has to be the dude symbol. I'm gonna put it right there. Say, yes, it's a private bedroom, and whose is it? It's mine. So this is cool, because I believe everybody's got their own room. So I actually finished that. Let me go down and get all this stuff. Nice, get more goo. I have an item that... I don't know if it completely nullifies, but it lessens fall damage. It goes in like a relic slot in my inventory, and I actually have two of those slots, and one of them's currently wide open. I don't have anything in it. That is the only relic I've encountered so far in the game, so... Eagerly anticipate getting another one. Okay. Night has fallen over Jonestown. I think I'm gonna run from you, but I'm not. And this has actually been bugging me. I need to do this. Hold on. I need a brazier. Oh, the old ducklings are in here. Oh, and I did have a campfire in there. I didn't mean to do that. Just need one. Take out one. And actually give me one of those. Two. Who's the archer? Hey! Mind your own business, buddy! I love that. I love how alive that feels. This game is fun. There, that helps a little bit. It's very dark in that room. Just wanna make these. Keep it distant to each other. There we go. That looks better. Mind your own business, buddy. Make sure I didn't miss anything. Oh, man! Max Zeichen? Or Zeichen, you're a subscriber now! Hell yeah. Okay, cool. Let me go drop these off in my... What is that thing? A whopping needle? That's a first. Don't believe I've encountered a whopping needle before. Let me go cook that egg. And this game's not, like, difficult, you know? This game's not that hard, but it's fun. It's not about the game being challenging. It's just the joy of building this world. So Pippa's on her bed. Nobody's in my room, which they shouldn't be. You're a madman, and you're just walking around because that's how you roll. LaRouche is in his room. Sheridan is in his room. Rolo's in his room, and Magnus is in his room. How awesome is that? I love that. So yeah, there shouldn't be beds in here. That makes no sense. Get out of your beds. Wait. The max level of a base is 5? Or maybe, is that my max level for where I'm at in the story? I wonder. Weird. We should probably put some sconces up in people's rooms and stuff. This place gets pretty dark at night. Okay. So we got a couple minutes left in the stream. Madman. I think it was Magnus. And it's daytime. Here comes everybody. Here comes Pippa from upstairs. Wait, I have to make more. Okay, so is my inventory clean now? Okay, I'm a little bit hungry. So, yeah, let's go get that bed. I want that to be my bed. Let's go steal the bed. And then we'll wrap up the stream by defending that attack, which I don't think will be very difficult, but it's still fun. Let's save it. Because, I mean, all about that, too. Okay, yes, there. Whoa, ramshackle mess, that's epic. I wish that was true. That'd be great. I'll just say it is. I'll say it's true for now. Okay, so that castle, I don't even think that castle's like past here. Maybe it is? I thought maybe the castle's over there, but that doesn't make any sense. Yeah, I think the castle is through there. One of the things I like is if you pass a specific armor, some people don't mess with you. Like they're like a little bit less inclined to just run at you and start attacking. But the skeleton didn't care. He was gonna throw down, but. So again, I don't have to worry about my inventory filling up unless I need to access those things quickly. In which case, then I'm screwed. Okay, so I think I can't go over there. That's cut off from that island. You can't swim, and to my knowledge, you can't build boats in this game, which sucks, but oh well. Something Minecraft has on it. I think even the original Minecraft, the beta release of Minecraft, had boats, but whatever. That's basically how the game does levels and, like, restricts you from areas and tells a story, so I guess I'll give it that allowance. Is not almost November, it is October. October is the best month ever. Is that guy still down there? There's a guy down there that wants to make this a better cemetery than it is. And he wants me to, or is that guy? I don't know. Maybe I can't see him from that high up. Yeah, so this is like the first place you teleport to, so I just destroy guys in this area now. They don't do a lot of damage. I increase my hit points by eating these guys, the Seeds of Life. I'm saving those around. I'm saving those because, oh yeah, look, I made a little. Made a little staircase over here. Little dirt staircase. Then I think. Made a little staircase over here. So I don't know if the trees grow back. I'm not sure actually how to. I know how to plant certain trees, but when you leave, when you knock something down and leave like a tree stump, I don't know what the consequences are there. Find that castle. But like my this game took my breath away when I saw that castle because, you know, it was just at the point where you're like, oh, I can almost, you know, make a room out of stone, and then all of a sudden you see this gigantic castle, you know, with all these amazing, like, I smashed down, like, chandeliers and all this stuff. I stole so much from that castle. But I can't believe I missed the bed. I got wheat here. I actually, Ben showed me where that was. I totally missed wheat in the natural progression of the game. And when Pippa was like, I want you to make bread. I'm like, I don't know how to make bread. Oh, there it is. Okay. There's the castle in the distance. I should make like a road or something that just leads straight there. Should figure out where that is in relation to where I get dropped off in this world. Just make like a, you know, just burrow a road that just goes straight there. So whenever I come back. So there's a couple of like dings in this castle, but other than that, it's a pretty sweet castle. So if I wanted, I could smash up this entire thing and steal every single block. But I don't know. Like, RP-wise, I kind of want to... I think I would... I mean, this floor, it's so tempting to just rip this whole floor up and steal it. But I kind of want to, like, restore this castle to its former glory. Like, these things I bet I could smash. Okay. Where's that bed at? Oh, the bed! Oh, look at this gorgeous, gorgeous bed. Yes! Did I learn how to make it? Oh, I got a little... Oh, and what on earth is this? Oh, I want to steal you. That was that. Okay, great. So tempting. And then there's like all this roofing and stuff. Okay, I'm taking the bed. Because no one's sleeping here. You know, like... And look, you got those sconces, like the fancy, like, Haunted Mansion sconces, the flags, I bet you can knock those down. There's a way to get up here, but I think it's like, there's boxes there I can smash up. Yeah, I think I, like, repaired this a little bit. Yeah, built this here. Ooh, yeah, can I smash you? Cool. Cell door. I like that they tell you when the first time you get something is. It's a good feeling. Look, man, I talked to the spirits of the people who used to live here. And they said this place is like ramshackle. Take whatever you want. Because they're like, well, I don't need it anymore. They actually gave me other things. They, like, trained me and, you know, one person gave me a recipe for how to build something. I can't remember. And it is my intention to restore this castle to its former glory. So I will return, random cell on the second floor. I will return and, you know, put this place back together. Because this is not, I want my castle to be different. You know, like, this looks like a very regal, this looks like it's a kind of castle, like, nobody really lives here. I did a little bit of scavenging. This is when I grabbed all the stuff before. So, cool, I got the bed. So, check out this awesome item. Run out here. As long as... Oop. As long as I'm out in the open. And use a Chimera Wing, which I guess you could do in the original Dragon Quest. This is a sequel to the original Dragon Quest, by the way. Which is cool. I love that the deluxe bed is four spaces big instead of just two. Sweet. So. Yes. Yes. His first master bedroom. Fancy bed, chair, fancy light source. But yes. Yes. Oh, thanks. See, he's the only one that's awake. So usually when you build a new room or you get like a big achievement like that, everybody in the town, this is adorable. Everybody in town comes running and congratulates you, but everyone's asleep. And it's just this crazy guy. Stop it jumping on. Okay, I'm gonna, okay. I know I don't have any ore. I know this is wasteful. Or coal, I need coal. But I can't take it anymore. These people jumping up and in and out of my room. Stop it. I'm at my wit's end. Wait, no. Oh, wait, yeah, actually I have. Oh, there, okay. So let me put some of this away. A comfy stool. And a door. Picked up a little bit of castle wall. That stuff away in a second. My room is not a playground. I don't want you jumping around on stuff. I need to respect my boundaries. I'm Brandon the Builder. Oh, for people who tuned in earlier, I played a little Game of Thrones before we started. As a joke, and one person asked, is that a Game of Thrones reference? It is. Brandon the Builder built the wall. And if you are a fan of Game of Thrones, you are very familiar with the wall, and all of the crazy stuff that goes down there. Brandon the Builder built that. Brandon the Builder is a Stark, and Brandon, is a very common name in the Stark family. I believe Ned's brother was named Brandon, and, Bran is short for Brandon, Bran Stark. So, hopefully this will keep people not jumping around in my room. Okay, I only have one of these things left. I hope you're happy. I had to use up all but one of these. Gotta make more of that. Okay. Again, I'm sorry, I'm just super uptight about where things have to go in specific places. This is food and stuff, so that goes in there. And then the stuff is just like regular old materials you use to make random stuff. That all goes in there. And then keep a little bit of dirt and all the plants out in the front here. Cool. So when, looks like everybody's gonna wake up soon. When Rolo wakes up, we will address the issue that there are a bunch of monsters that are attacking, inevitably going to attack my town. Rolo, I'm ready. Let's do it. And again, this is a fun teleporter. Takes you to another realm. A realm of desert. Looks like Super Mario Bros. 3. See, I've already, like, heavily excavated this area. Oh, wait, hold on. I need to catch these things. Sometimes they drop stakes. And I would like to make a bunch of those. No stakes? Okay. Scorpion, look, I don't know. Scorpion, I'm so much more stronger. I'm so much stronger than you now. It's not even. You were intimidating when I first started playing this game, but this is not anymore. Okay, let's do this. Go back. Alright, Roll, let's do it. Okay, all right, I'm so ready. Love this, the old school, you're gonna go into combat transition. And I believe all the music is the same. Oh, look at all these remnants of things that have died on my doorsteps. Okay, so look at this. So it surprises, so sometimes when they charge, they'll go down, they'll drop down. But then he just can't Let's see if he'll smash through. Nope. You're so confused. Oh. Oh, it's so good. Come on, man. Self-preservation, Scorpion. Come on. Oh, it's so good. So gratifying. So I don't know how long this will last. Like, again, I'm still in chapter one, so I don't know if they throw crazy monsters at me. So the leader of the monsters, here he comes. And again, I'm really taking my time with this game. So he does, like, a charge attack that'll drop him down. But I just don't know if that'll be enough. This is going to take a long time. Brandon, if you have the spin attack, try mining with it. Oh, okay, yeah. Oh, yeah! That's a good call. I wonder if that'll actually save time, though. Because once you get the better mallets, you can mine pretty fast. All right, let me go run and mess this guy up. Come on, buddy. Whoa. Sometimes the villagers will come out and fight with me, but looks like they are okay staying inside for now. Bring it, dude. I actually took out some of those spikes. Woohoo! Oh, and I got another teleport! Oh no! A whole new area! Everyone's gonna be so stoked. Watch, they're so happy. They're all saying different things. And we have new quests now. Sheridan has made an incredible job stopping all those monsters. Not only that, you found a new teleporter tool. Remarkable. Oh, and by the way, LaRouche told me what happened. It was the golem who crushed Cantlin into dust. If that's the case, then there's no doubt about it. The monster that rules over these lands is the same golem that guarded Cantlin. Brandon, do you know what this means? I can help. I can finally help. After all my years of wandering, I finally found a place where I can be of use. Once during my travels, I met an inventor who taught me how to build things called wrecking balls. If the golem were to attack us, something as powerful as the wrecking ball would be absolutely invaluable. Let me teach you how to make them. I've never been able to build one myself, so I can't wait to see if they work. I'm so down. Let's do it. Yes, I figured it out. An explosive steel sphere filled with fulminary fragments explodes a short time after being placed. Oh, okay. Oh, and I got a new person! I gotta make a room for you! Hey, what's up? What is this wonderful place? It's so bright and warm. She reminds me of that tiger lady from Chrono Trigger. Can't remember her name, sorry. All accepting that cold look on your face, young man, or perhaps not. Your face might be cold, but I can see the fire in your eyes. You want to know what I'm doing here this late in the day, don't you? There's no point trying to deny it. I can read you like an open book. This place looks like the perfect city, full of buildings and people and light. The truth is, everyone who lives here seems awfully anxious. Personally, the only thing I feel is exhausted from walking all the way here. I hope you don't mind if I join you. My name is Sherry. I don't have any particular... Oops, sorry. Presumptive there, pressing the button. Let me put a bed back in here. Take out just one. That's why I actually had the bed in here. So that, you know, if we have a new guest, you can crash in here. But she seems cool. Oh, she came in and she changed her outfit! She went into the dress, she went into the armory, and went over to this like, dress thing and changed her outfit in real time. That was sweet. Again, this game is so cartoony and childish. I know, but it's just those, like, little details that I enjoy way more than I should. Again, let's put all of this crap away. In the place where it goes, so we know where we can find it. We got chains, in case we need to put chains on the wall. A pair of unescapable iron manacles designed to handcuff hostages to the wall. Like, whoa. This game gets serious, apparently. Hopefully not. Here's all the food bits. Oh, she's already making food. She's going to town. Got some more shrooms on a stick. Okay, so I guess I'll just lay this down here for now, but I might be like a little more creative in how I build that in the future, but for now. Ba-da-da-da, the Green Island. Green Island Crunch, everybody. Silk, just so excited. Everybody's so thrilled. Aw, oh, thanks. Aw, oh, you guys are the best. What equipment do we? I don't have a ton to... I guess we're okay. Damn right. Armor's a little dinged up. You can't repair stuff, which is weird. As far as I know, you can't repair armor. Set that up, but alright, so hopefully it's not spoilers. I'm gonna go and check out this green world. If you don't want to see more of the game, then you can bail. I'm only gonna play this game for about 5 or 10 more minutes because I got another stream coming up tonight. Brandon, you may want to buy, get some chiropractors for all the people sleeping on stone floors. Yeah. Yeah, now get back to work, peasants. They're working pretty hard. I mean, he's cleaning up his room. I would like beds, though. Let me just see. Hold on a second before I head over there. Let's see if I can make a wrecking ball. Rock bomb shard. No idea what that is. Maybe we're about to find out. Here we go. It's fun. I'm happy to be hanging out with you when I discovered this land for the first time. Where am I? What on earth is the... Okay, here we go. I think this is a rock bomb. A sleeping rock bomb. Oh, geez. Whoa. What is it doing? Whoa, what is happening right now? Whoa! Wow! Wow, that was like a creeper. That was the Dragon Quest Builder's version of the creeper, everybody. I wonder if I could have taken it out before it did that. I have never seen that many items pop out of anything in the time I have played this game so far. I feel bad because it, like, messed this up. I'm glad it didn't do it there near the pedestal. It would have destroyed that pedestal. That was sweet. I wonder how many people in chat knew that was going to happen. Did I get the thing? I still didn't get what I'm looking for. The shard of the whatever. Brandon obtains his first clump of the finest... Oh! A sturdy suit of impenetrable steel plate. Defense 26. Oops, wait. What am I wearing? Ooh! Okay, short trip. Going back. Excuse me. I guess I just needed that fur. It's all about that fur. It's Geodude. Yeah, it's a pretty... Yeah, it's a dangerous Geodude. Everybody's going to bed. Good night, everybody. Oh, man, can I make that? Bolt blade armor. Steel ingot finest for a cord. Uh-huh. Yes, please. Oh, so many delicious crunches we're having today on this Dragon Quest stream. Yes. Full plate armor. Sweet. Super crazy defense. And my base is still max level. Oh, wait. So let me drop off my old iron armor there. Grab these two while I'm at it. And let me put some stuff. God, that thing exploding. That was so funny. seen that. Okay. So that's like incidental stuff. This box is blocks that have been built. This box is blocks that I found naturally in the environment, so like sand and dirt and stuff like that. This is decorations. Just functional things around the house. Oh, and I regenerate health when I come back to the base. Oh, I never knew that. I never knew if you, like, regenerated health if you slept or stuff like that. Oh, and I'm putting you down. That's right. Nice. 500 points for that guy. Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, we got a little bit more time. Let's just venture a little bit further into this realm. Some things. Attacking the base. Not going so well for them. Yep, both dead. Actually, I haven't slept in my room yet. I'm gonna sleep in my room. You can see the guy beneath me. You can see the quest that I'm on with him. The big chest allows access from anywhere. Oh, cool. I assume you have to kill for the shard, not let it explode. Oh, I gotta kill for the shard. Okay. I might not get it from him, though. I didn't even see what type of enemy that was. But yeah, I guess I just gotta wail on him when he starts doing that crazy attack. Let's try it. Do not forget to replace those broken spike traps. Okay, wait. Points. Points for remembering the broken spike traps outside. I'm sorry. I am that obsessive. I full stop when he brought you right. I would not have noticed that until the next time I went outside. Wait, no. Somebody's bedroom. I believe it was 3, but I'm just going to grab the whole lot. I love the big door. I was really happy when I got that. It's like, oh yeah, because my... When in my town, when the door out front was just like... Oh yeah, let's get a couple more items here. Ooh, did I get an ingot? Oh, sweet. That ingot may save a life someday. I gotta make this into grass, too. That is also bugging me. Ooh! Took out a couple. Just scope out here for damage. Looks okay. I love how some of committed you are. You know, Twitch viewers, allies, if you're down, I will stream a lot of this game. I'm going to be playing a ton of this game. And so it's like, as long as I'm playing it, might as well stream it. I mean, not all of it. I think I should take some breaks and then, you know, come back to y'all and be like, hey, look what I built. Look what I've been up to. But, like, no. When you start up this game in the menu, I'll show it to you when we leave. I'll show you what I'm assuming they are telling us that we can build in this game. And like, I've not caught up on this game as far as the, obviously this game's been out for a long time in Japan, so like, if I wanted, I could see the whole game online. I haven't, intentionally, so. Yeah, what did I get? I got an iron. Okay, steel's better than iron, but nice. Oh, we got a sub! Heal Guy G, you're a subscriber now! Love and respect. Oh, and we never opened this guy. Ooh, green Naviglobe. So yeah, the green Naviglobes are something that is probably really, really awesome and would make my game experience a lot better. And so naturally, I haven't really used or experimented with. But I think that's like, if you put it down somewhere, then you can, like, see it. So it's basically like, you have quest markers. You can see in the map in the right corner there. I have a flag. That's basically where my base is. It doesn't mean I can walk there because I'm on an island. So if I wanted to, I could leave that Naviglobe back where the teleporter is, which is probably a smart idea. Let me go do that now. So then I can always tell where that is and get back to it. But I can pick up the Naviglobe and move that Naviglobe anywhere. So I believe that's how that works, but let me Right now I'm keeping the Nava Globes in that, like, armory area. Ooh, I gotta put a chest in my room, too, and keep all my private documents in there. There we go. Got some steak. Not seen. Okay. Put it right next to the chest. Yeah, look, and there's a little green dot. So that'll help me get back to... Ooh, there's a little pink ore? I don't know what that is. Oh, there's one. Okay, here we go. Okay, that's not that bad. Whoa, that's a cool animation. Nice. I'm gonna eat one of these, which makes my health improve and fills it, so. Let's see if this guy will tussle with me. Yeah, there we go. He's ready. Ready to give me some materials. Uh-oh, guys, don't mess with me. Not now. Not now. Oh, no. Come on, come on. Oh, that was close. Cool, I just needed three of those, so I can go back and make some cool stuff. But, let's, so cool, this is kind of a canyon area, I guess. Again, I haven't seen those rock guys, but I've seen forms like this before. Again, this didn't, like, send me to another dimension. This is island I can probably see from another part in the game. This is maybe an island that appeared in the distance. I might not be that far from my original area. I'll use the other seed of life. There we go. Filling up that health. So yeah, these steaks I can make burgers out of, and the burgers increase my attack power for a little bit, so. If I ever encounter a boss fight in this game that I am not able to handle... Ooh, let's see what that pink stuff is right there. I'm gonna roll right into the Red Dead stream. First chunk of ruby! Okay, let's just run around. Real quick. Just see what's what. Okay, more of these guys. Maybe I can climb up top there and see what's going on elsewhere. More rabbits, right on. Okay. What are you? Ah! Sorry, moving along. Oh, I think that's... Which way? Oh, are you nothing? Did you just smash apart? Yeah, you're nothing. Okay. You're nothing! You're not even a mineral! It's just like void rock. Leave me alone. I'm just exploring. Leave me alone. I got no beef with you yet. I wonder if the hammer hurts him more. There is a hammer that I've learned how to make, but it is so cool, I do not... Cannot make it yet. I think I need coal to make that thing, too. So I need lots of coal, okay? Alright. So if I wanted to, I could just kind of up and go over this this wall here. But usually these islands have at least one point of interest. That's kind of just what I'm looking for to add a little spicy crunch to this stream, but... not seeing it? But this seems... The natural progression of the level seems to be taking me in this direction. It is nighttime, unfortunately, so... Even if we get there, might not see it. What's fun about this game, though... Yeah, weird. Okay, well, you've seen that zone. Maybe I didn't spoil it for you, so that was good. You lose! Good day, sir! You get nothing! Okay. First thing we're gonna do, we're gonna put some ore in here. stuff in the other rooms. And I love this. This never gets old. I never get back to town and I'm like, oh, I gotta put all this stuff away. I have a feeling where I'm like, wow, look at all the stuff I got. I can't wait to put that in the places where it goes. Just weird like that. It just gets me. Gets me all psyched up. It's like going back to the base in XCOM. You're just like, okay. I got all sorts of stuff I gotta do. Gotta level you up. Gotta assign this to you. Yeah, I'm gonna put the finest fur in the other room. Put my little flower over here. Nope. Put you away. Put you in here. Leave the fur in here, because it looks like I make suits out of it so far. And then, I know you're sleeping, but I'm so excited. Oh, wait, no, I gotta build them first. I just built a wrecking ball. Let's see if he wakes up. No, he's not awake. I'll wake him up. Dude, I built him. Brandon the Builder. So there's an interesting golem or not golem debate. Some people think the golem is a threat. Some people don't. Some people are like, the golem's fine. He's our friend. Build 20 wrecking balls? I'll build more than that. And right back to sleep. Cool. I wonder who the next quest comes from. Oh. It comes from the Pipster. What up, Pip? Sorry to wake you up. It looks like you got something to say. Oh, hey, Brandon. I don't know if you've noticed, but everyone's been acting really nervously recently. Uh-oh. I asked Rollo what was going on, and he told me a ginormous monster is going to attack us any moment now. All I want to do is build a city where we can all live together in peace. So why did I have to end up like this? Brandon, this monster is going to attack us. It's really powerful, isn't it? I know I shouldn't be bothering you at a time like this, but I'm really scared that somebody's going to get hurt. Which is why I'm wondering, could you make some medicinal herb for me? Just 5 pouches? Oh, yeah. 5. Yeah, like in my sleep. I think I have 5 pouches. Yeah. Is that all? I did that even before you woke up. Oops. She probably just told me something really profound. What? If I was going to give them to you, why did you ask you to make them for me? Well, it's just that you've been so busy building rooms and furniture and weapons for everyone else. You haven't been taking any time to look after yourself. Aw. So I just wanted to make something to keep yourself healthy in the last big battle. Oh, and Brandon, do you think you can build that Cantlin shield thing Rollo was talking about too? No matter how horrible the monsters might be, I don't want to have to fight them. But on the other hand, I'd be so sad if the town you worked so hard to build for it got destroyed. Nothing has really been a threat so far, Pippa. You need to calm down. So please, Brandon, you've got to work out how to build that Cantlin shield to protect our city. Got it. Pinky swear. I don't know how I got back more than I gave her, but... Oh, and now I know how to make it? Oh, okay. A durable defensive wall that can block any enemy's attack can be retrieved by pressing X. Weird. I wonder how that works. Well, that's a story for another day. I will build that Cantlin shield, and I will use it. I'm actually gonna... Here, let's crunch on this. Seed of Life... My HP is now at 100, and I'm going to save it. And it is 9:49 in 10 minutes. I will be returning to Twitch with a completely different stream. This is my town. This is Jonestown. But check this out. So this is what's kind of frustrating. I can't, like... Oh, exit game. There we go. Look at that. Yeah. So check this out. Look at that town. Look at that thing in the distance. Like, look at that thing in the back left. I'm building that because we have to go up. Like, you have to build this thing like a skyscraper because there's only so much width and length to the whole thing that you can build. So you're forced to go up. And I can't help but think that that's like, you know, they're baiting you to build that thing. That they're like, that's it. With the moat and the little... With the... archways and all that stuff. Yeah, go nuts. Or maybe I'm looking too far into that. So we saw that little castle. We saw what can't be done. But I will get back to it. I will spend a little more time with this. Thanks for tuning in. I'm going to be back in 10 minutes. But thank you for hanging around for just a quick little stream. There's a dragon in each teleportal to kill, too. Oh, man. See, there's so much. Or teleport. In each teleported area. On each island, you can teleport, too. Yeah, I'll be back in a little bit. I just wanted to play this for a little bit, and I will play more of it soon. Thank you for joining me. I'll see you soon. Take care, everybody. Very, very soon.